The eternal God is our dwelling place. We can cast our burdens upon the Lord, and He will sustain us. God of creation, we worship You. Giver of life, we praise You. Spirit of resurrection, we find hope in You. As the family and friends of Jane Kurtz gather to celebrate her life, we give thanks for the courage and faith we saw in Jane every day of her life. Jane was a hope-filled woman. She was more than hopeful. I'll always remember her as hope-filled. She was brimming over with optimism, with what tomorrow might bring. And so we gather to say goodbye, and we ask for Jane's measure of faith to be ours in this hour. Psalm 121 sings, I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where does my help come from? My help comes only from the Lord, the maker of heaven and of earth. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade by your right hand. The sun will not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all that is evil. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in, now and forevermore. In 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, the Apostle Paul writes, what I am saying to you then, sisters and brothers, is that this flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Behold, I will tell you a mystery. We will not all die, but we will be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For this perishable body must put on the imperishable, and this mortal body will be clothed in immortality. When this perishable body puts on the imperishable, and this mortal body puts on immortality, then it will be finished. Scripture will be fulfilled. Death will be swallowed up in victory. And one of Jane's very favorite scriptures from the Gospel of John. Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not true, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And when I prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you with me, that you may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas then said to him, "Lord, I don't know the place. Will you show me the way?" Jesus answered, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one would come to the Father except by me. If you love me, you know and love my Father as well." Let us pray. Almighty God, your love never fails as you turn the shadow of death into a new dawn. May we receive your words with believing hearts that we might claim your promise of resurrection. Loving God, allow us to worship even as we grieve. Help us to celebrate the life of Jane Kurtz even in the midst of our sorrow. Jane's life as a daughter, sister, wife, mother, grandmother, and recently great-grandmother. Her life as an aunt, a great aunt, a professional woman, and friend. Like our Savior, Jane enjoyed hard work, but always looked forward to time around the table. So, gracious God, may we remember her when we come to the table in your house and in our own homes. Our loving God, she loved the flowers of natures and the flowers that she grew. May we, when we glimpse the flowers in this beautiful place, the flowers in our own yard, remember her, and remember that even in the twinkling of an eye, she has joined you for all eternity. In the name of the resurrection and the life, we pray. Amen.
And the joy we share.
The gospel story, the good news, is the story of God constantly taking the initiative. It's the story of God reaching out again and again to be in relationship with each of us. Even as a parent seeks a warm and trusting relationship with the child, so does God with each of us. After all, we were created to live in fellowship with God, and we never truly find peace until we make our journey safely back into God's arms. Scripture is the story of God reaching out to each of us. In the Hebrew scripture, we read of the Garden of Eden and of Noah and God's special covenant and of Abraham and Sarah. And then God reaches out in a mighty and decisive way in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. But the story, we are told, does not end there. For the Apostle Paul writes, God sends us anew. And this is the mystery that has been hidden from the generations. It is now made known to us, which is Christ in you, God's hope and glory. Paul tells us that the new mystery is that God is in us. Christ is in each of us, God's hope and glory. I chose this text because again and again, I saw Jesus reaching out through Jane. I saw Jesus when she spoke of her family, whom she loved so very much. I heard Jesus when she asked me about her friends, so many who will wait for her with the saints of eternity, and so many who would be here today, but they are in their 90s themselves. I saw her faith when she would speak about the farm. I saw her joy in Christ when she would tell me about the trips she'd made with her family and those special longer trips she'd made with her beloved sister. And always, I could see how she missed TC, her husband, and the faith and hope she had that he was safe in God's hands. Like Jesus, Jane also enjoyed time around the table. Danny confirmed again and again how much their family loved to come around the table and share a meal. And I'd heard many years ago from her friends at church that Jane was indeed a wonderful cook. No wonder the family looked forward to their time together. Jane loved Jessamine County, where she'd lived for all 93 years of her life. That's amazing. She worked 42 years as the vice president of Farmers Bank. She was a member of Nicholasville Christian Church and Circle 4. And I know that several of the white roses have the names of Circle 4 members on them. She was also a volunteer for the hospice and the treasurer for Jessamine County Board of Education for many years. Jane loved her grandchildren, Andy and wife Julia and Matt, and we mustn't forget the newest member of the family, Hudson. Oh, the stories you will be able to tell him about Jane. You can tell him how much Jane loved Christmas. She was always ready for the Christmas season. Jenny told me of one year when her own work was to the point she didn't believe she'd be able to decorate the way she loved and the family enjoyed. She mentioned that to her mom. And upon coming home from work one evening, she found her home decorated from top to bottom. Mom had been there. The house was ready for Christmas. And I've learned that Jane, after the big Christmas meal, which was a must, could hardly get ready for the dessert because she was anticipating opening the presents. She loved the time around the tree. She couldn't wait to see what was in those brightly colored boxes. She was, as the family said, the biggest kid there was around the Christmas tree. And we'll remember Jane's faith. Jenny and Danny both remarked how often she'd say something like, "God has this covered," or "God will take care of this." I heard those very same words one afternoon when I went to visit her and she had had a very, very difficult therapy session. It hurt her quite a bit. But she pulled herself together and looked up to me and said, "When I go back this afternoon, God's going to have to take care of this." She had faith. Oh, she knew she'd need to work hard, but she had faith that God would indeed be there. And that, yes, God would take care of it. So, what will you remember? Her flower garden, the flowers she loved to have in the summer in her home, watching a UK football or basketball game. I was surprised to know she loved both. In Kentucky, we have a lot of basketball fans, but she enjoyed football too. Will you remember her quilting, family trips? Many of you don't know it, and I certainly didn't, but I found out that she could also really hit a softball a very long ways. And I'm sure she'll always be remembered in that very special way on Christmas. One evening I'd gone up to visit her. Her family had left earlier. Her dinner hadn't been as good as she had hoped it to be. She had pretty high expectations for how a dinner should be prepared. We visited for a while, and I'd been reading that afternoon from a book of my favorite poetry by the poet Murray Bodo. I read her one of his poems, and she liked it. We prayed around that poem a little later, and I think it describes her life so well. Her life, as the Apostle Paul tells us, representing our Lord and Savior. Murray Bodo writes, "Jesus doesn't come once upon a time at Christmas. Jesus reoccurs to us each time we find God in another human being. People like you and me are, in fact, the body of Christ. When a neighbor delivers a dish for a funeral meal, when a friend calls you before your surgery, when someone volunteers to watch the kids for an afternoon, we have seen Jesus. Jane was a child of God, a disciple of her Lord, and in her presence, we always felt God's love." Let us pray. O God of love and mercy, we have come to you seeking comfort and promise. We thank you for the life of Jane. It is with sadness that we bid farewell, but we have hope. Speak peace to Jenny, Danny, Andy, and his wife, Julia, and Matt. Hold the little Hudson in the palm of your hand. Bless Jane's family that are here and are listening. Bless all of Jane's friends and her beloved members of Circle 4. In the name of Jesus, our resurrection and our life, we pray. Amen. Blind, but now I see. O Lord, our merciful God, into your hands receive your servant, a child of your own creating, a lamb of your own flock, a sheep of your own pasture, a sinner of your own redeeming. Our gracious God, receive Jane into your eternal care. And now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
This concludes our service here at the funeral home. We'll be going to Maple Grove for a final committal service there. If you plan to go to the cemetery with us, please use your hazard lights when you are going from here to the cemetery so that we know you're with us in the procession going from here. We will exit out the side door so you all can be dismissed from the back and come up this way and say goodbye to Danny and Jenny and exit out the side.